Far beyond witches and wizards is the root cause of health problems of many in Africa. Seek professional advice concerning that your health matter.
I see with my clear eye. The eye that I cannot be rarely used in 2 years ago. I use it now to see everything. And I say, may God who make this man have this mind and all these doctors will be here. God will bless them and give them more life.
Join Dr. Save a Life Foundation.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now on AIT every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Hello, my pleasure to come your way again in this special edition of You and Your Health. I remain your friend, Dr. Richard Okoye, the president of Dr. Save a Life Foundation, a non-governmental organization with a clear vision of giving total health to the people of Africa through the power of knowledge. And we are on a mission of revolutionizing the mindset of our people when it has to do with health, and that has to do with the information you have to get today. It was a very explosive exposition last week when we discussed about diabetes, not a sugar problem, so strange as it were, but fantastically was able to deliver the message. So many people have been asking for that particular episode, and you have the privilege of visiting our website, www.drsavealife.org. Right there, you will see most of this very health information. Be empowered. Together, we will be able to build a healthy society. You know, it's so painful, and as I earlier told you, what motivated this very engagement on having Vision 2025. We had a program, a global health statistic program in the United States last year. And unfortunately, while most of the countries are already hitting 89, 85 years life expectancy, Nigeria unfortunately got seated in 217th position of life expectancy of 55 years. Completely unacceptable. When I come back, having identified some variables, we share the optimism that by the year 2025, Nigerian life expectancy will move from the current state, even deplorable as it were because of the issue of COVID, from 55 years to 70 years by 2025. I want you to get excited as we do. Perhaps why we are confident saying it, because we know more than you know. It is practicable, it is possible, but all through the power of knowledge. In today's edition, I have a very pathetic story to tell you. And this is what just happened last week, which changed the topic I'm to share with you today. And that has to be the death of a young, promising lady that died, this time not because of COVID, but he died because of fibroid. She was bleeding every month. According to the sister, every month she will bleed and bleed and bleed. And incidentally, in this last one, in the midst of COVID, she started bleeding. Sometimes the legs would be swollen and she was panting for breath. She couldn't walk. After a while, the family couldn't contain it. Before they brought her to the hospital, she was stone dead. Very heartbreaking experience of a young girl with such a wonderful future, according to the family history. But the one that touched me most, for which I deem it necessary for us to look at the fibroid treatment in the midst of 419 manipulations. Why do I have to say so? The story says that she was bleeding every month, and there was one spiritual merchant somewhere telling them that the problem is spiritual. If she gets to hospital, she will die. If anybody touches her, she will die in the theater. Nobody should know. It's not her portion. And this girl continued in the fear of the same, to the point that she died even before getting to the so-called hospital. In today's edition, I want us to practically, the one I'm going to tell you, we see it in the life of a lot of people, it's not just a story, okay? We will be in position to discuss what exactly killed that young lady. What? How did she die of fibroid? And many, as I'm talking to you right now, are somewhere also bleeding to death. What exactly killed her in the midst of COVID? Could her death result from COVID because it's already in our environment? Or is there any other thing other than fibroid that killed that young girl? We also will look into a very, very critical issue. This very fibroid that I'm talking about, is it a spiritual problem? We also will look into the fact that what they usually tell, if you go to hospital, you will die. Is there any spirit that is in the hospital that will kill these people faster? And then we tell them, no, don't go and do fibroid operation. If you do fibroid operation, you won't get pregnant again. How true is it? Where is the story coming from? That and many more. I will stand here today to be in position to reveal to you. Come on, not just for your sake, not for your consumption. Someone somewhere is under satanic bondage by reason of ignorance, also taking a toll of what happened to that young girl. And I want you to go out there to deliver them through the power of the knowledge you will get today. I want you to invite your friends, everyone you know, to hook into this very station right now. And I tell you, what you are to deliver them by inviting them to know is more than the money you will say, I'm spending to help you, I'm spending to pay for it, because many of them are already chained in the same mentality I'm to share with you now. Do it, I'll be right back. And when I come back, it's going to be a bomb revelation towards the goal, 2025. It will be a good news for all. I'll be right back. Ignorance is the mother of personal destruction, a voluntary misfortune, and it is worse when you are ignorant of your ignorance. Doing something same way, expecting a different result, is another demonstration of madness. If you have done what you think you know concerning that your health problem, why not seek for professional advice? If you lose money, you lose something. But if you lose your health, you lose everything. Hear this, you don't need things to enjoy life. You need life to enjoy things. Give your health professional attention.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. You're new on your health, a program sponsored by Dr. Save a Life Foundation. Today, I share with you a very, very particular story of a young lady that bled to death because of the issue of fibroid. The family couldn't bring her to hospital on time. She died. And the story was that there was a prophet telling her that her problem is spiritual. If she gets to hospital, she will die. And this lady bled like that, and bled like that, and bled like that until she passes away. The critical question we have to answer today is fibroid a spiritual problem? Is it a spiritual manipulation? I'm here to put it to you that fibroid is the commonest gynecological tumor. It is palpable. It is something you can touch. Have a look at this. If you have a look at this, you can see these are fibroids removed from a person. You can touch it. It's not spirit. Let nobody deceive us here. These are something you can touch, you can feel. It can be removed from the womb of our women. Very pathetic to tell you that because of ignorance of this fact, majority of our women has been victim of all manner today. Fibroid as small as this will be allowed to grow and most times take over the entire womb. Have a look at this. it will beat your imagination that what looks like pregnancy with these women are not fibroid. All these things you are seeing here are not pregnancy. The fibroid that was allowed under this same deception, it is an attack. If you take this one and all manner of products that are just given to them, and you can look at these women under this kind of being victim of such a thing that otherwise could be in position to be prevented.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
I cannot believe it that this is the same me that came here with not having the hope of being on my feet again, that I can walk again like a normal human being. I want to thank Doctors Save a Life Foundation for this wonderful work. To God and to God only be the glory.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now, having been able to establish the fact that fibroid is not a spiritual problem. It's a biological and also a gynecological tumor known over the years. We want to also establish what is therefore responsible for the death of that young lady that bled until the family told that she became so tired, not able to walk, she was just panting until she is gone. When I explain what I'm going to explain to you, you will also know what most of our hypertensive patients, they are passing through when it has to do with heart failure. Now, what that young lady suffered was heart failure, but in her own case, not because the heart had problem, but because of what is called anemic heart failure. The heart was not having enough blood anymore to be in position to circulate the blood that will sustain this young lady living again. Hear me and hear me well, because we are in a life-saving mission here. When a woman is menstruating, that particular woman is doing what is physiologically normal every month. But there is a uniqueness you must note as a woman or somebody who cares for them, is that a woman menses, the menstrual blood of a woman does not clot. What do I mean by not clotting? It doesn't come in block of blood. It comes like water because of the fibrogenic nature of it. However, when you see yourself as a woman, now menstruating as you used to, but the menses is getting longer than the number of days you used to bleed, or you suddenly discover that this your blood that used to come like water is suddenly coming in lumps of blood, in small blocks. What that thing is telling you, you are no longer losing your menses. You are losing your own blood, because at that point, something is wrong in you. And when a woman is pouring this kind of blood every month she's pouring the blood, over the time, the blood level will be low. And what are the signs of you noticing that your blood level, if you see the woman that used to be very pink, if you check the eye, the light will be beginning to be a little bit whitish. And for you as the person, you also notice that they may even complain to you and say that if he gets a little thing, he will feel a little dizzy. You know what's happening? The blood was not enough to be able to carry oxygen, carry glucose to the brain. And after a while, he may feel sad. Over the time of that development, when the heart cannot pump, it doesn't have what to pump. You know what will happen? She will now develop what is called anemic heart failure. Sometimes you will see the leg will be swollen. If she gets what she used to do, normally she start panting as if she's just fainting. In a small distance or in a small walk, she will be panting. And tell me what will happen when a young girl is also exhibiting symptoms that have been looking at that of COVID. In a time like this, we can't allow these ones to continue to die. We cannot allow them to come to that extreme where confusion will be between what they're supposed to be assisted for and what is still looking suspicious because of the time we are. That's why it is important for me to state this. There are people that their religious faith don't consider issue of blood. something like Jehovah's Witness and all that, be it unto you according to your faith. But I cry to them as a member of our society, and I cry to them as being the people we must protect in line with Vision 2025, that our life expectancy will no longer be what it is right now. And I advise, when you are out of the option of taking blood, do not allow your members to keep on actively bleeding, because usually blood for blood, if that life will be saved. Unfortunately, our own case is different. Different from the fact that we have today in our society, a lot of spiritual merchants. People will have HIV instead of taking the drugs available that have saved many people today that are even non-detectable by reason of the drug they're taking. They will get somewhere, they will say, don't take your drugs. It is a spiritual attack. It is a manipulation. That is the society we find ourselves. As I'm talking right now, there are people right there. I think you have to get involved to rescue them. Demon attack. Even in this COVID, how many demons have we consumed? Yet, we are still living. Deception per excellence, as it were. If you have a health problem, start from the known. Before you go to the unknown. If you get to the unknown, we have already been informed against God's power to defend you against your known. Why is the counterfeit of devil, demon, attack that has kept your life? When attention can be given to our people, when they have problem or cancer that can be cured. Today we can't assess those cases, because any presentation on any case, including cancer, is as good as prevention. We don't have that opportunity in this country. But we have to be in position to deliver these ones through the power of knowledge. Fibroid is not demonic. Fibroid is not a satanic manipulation. Going to the hospital does not mean if you go there, you will die. Any person that tells you that is just to keep you until death do you pass. That young girl is in the grave. Everyone will be talking, no, it's a satanic attack. For how long can we begin to celebrate such mediocrity? How long? True knowledge shall the just one be delivered. And we must be in position to start today to save value health, value life, and protect life. And that is what we are here for. And I want to encourage everyone to be part and parcel of this engagement. Stay tuned. When I come back, I will reveal to you what is an acid test. How you will be able to catch anyone telling you the solution to your fibroid is this or that and all that. I will be in position to reveal to you an acid test. Put it across to them and bust all those their deception. Stay tuned. I'll be right back.
I'm more than 50. But God, in His mercy and grace, today I can breastfeed.
I never dreamt in my life to be in India, neither enter plane before I die at the age of 70.
My vote of thanks to Doctor saving a life. I'm very happy with them. They've not revived my life again, no matter the age. Now, I feel I can live a little longer than I could have lived.
Join Dr. Save a Life Foundation.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. You're on You and Your Health, a program sponsored by Dr. Save a Life Foundation. Your support will be highly, highly appreciated. This very message has to go around. They say, we are not asking you in any way, give us money. No, you can make any of the station available for this very program to come to your people. Of course, being in this very station, you can admit with me, is financially demanding. Nevertheless, if we together can save a life, posterity will never forget us for this very venture. So today we are looking into the issue of fibroid, the deception and what's going on in our system. I want to round up today by being in position to give you what is called an acid test Of course, so many people may have told you, if you drink this drug, if you take this concoction, or if you take this supplement, fibroid will disappear. You must have heard of something like that. You must have been told you need to be in position to this. So many of our women have been victim of all this. Victim of that. Some of them molested in all manner of things. A lady went to somewhere and they opened her leg after molestation and they started wanting in the name of treating her for fibroid. She got terrible infection and eventually the vagina got open. Every month she will be having serious pain because of the cervical stenosis. Every month pain, the vagina, she can't use it again, even for the intercourse pain. Marriage was shattered because of the situation we have found ourselves where there is no knowledge, the people will perish. And I want to encourage you that we will be part of it. I'm here now with a strong burden that we end this menace in our society as I'm talking. And that has to do with an acid test you need to have as a woman. Hear me. Fibroid, as earlier mentioned, is not a spirit. You can touch it, and most importantly, you can know whether you have fibroid or not. You can. And how will you know? A simple pelvic scan will tell you that this very woman has fibroid. Alright? Now, if anybody tells you, you know, that what the Dr. Richard Okoye is talking, he's just talking because he's a medical doctor. He will not like to tell you that you can take your supplement, you can take your concussion or all manner of manipulation, they will tell you. I don't care. I'm also not in position to defend on that. But simple thing, you should know. What is that? Before you go into any form of the so-called treatment, first of all, go for pelvic scan. If you go for scan, the scan will tell you you have fibroid 1. It can even measure the number and the sizes of the fibroid. I won't mind. Take whatever they tell you. After 1 month, wisdom demands you say, before my engagement and after my engagement, what is the outcome? Don't know go where they ask you to go and do scan. Go on your own to another place and do a similar, another scan again. When you go there, get the report you got before, and then compare with this later one. If the fibroids are still there staring at you, do you need any prophet to be told you have been deceived? Can we think? Have we been so brainwashed in this society that you cannot have what is called analytical reasoning? You can't reason again. God don't have stupid children, for Christ's sake. He said, come, let all reason together. If you have done whatever you are claiming now you are doing, dying there without nobody to help you, and you look at the report, and you do again, you look at the report, can't you think? I'm here to speak to you in a manner you should understand. Hear me and hear me well, with every sincerity or purpose. The only way currently fibroid can be taken out of the body is by surgery. And this could be either by open surgery. As a matter of fact, because of certain advancement today, you can even do fibroid without a single blood transfusion. By the reason of the use of the diatomy, that enable blood loss to be absolutely minimal. And also, you can do the one that is called laparoscopy, that you don't even need to cut the body open. If you have a look at this, okay, if you have a look at this, you can have a look at it right now. This is the fibroid right there in the womb. But right now, by reason of this technology camera base, you could be in position to pick up the fibroid, and off it goes. That is called a laparoscopic myomectomy. In the same vein, you can also have what is called hysteroscopic resection or hysteroscopic myomectomy, whereby you have the fibroid that is sitting right inside the womb. It can also be in position to be taken out hysteroscopically. This one is, you don't need to go through the service to be in position to take it off. These are many more. Are the opportunity right there for you to be in position to take off fibroid. You can have it in a number of hospitals right here in Nigeria. But why should you be right there waiting in ignorance until fibroid takes over the womb by sodding, affecting the issue that has to do with their future fertility and also the issue that has to do with bleeding.
You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
As a matter of fact, what I'm beckoning on you, that fibroid can be professionally removed, because they used to deceive a lot of people. If you go for fibroid operation, you won't achieve pregnancy. Who told you? If fibroid is professionally done in a good time, you can achieve pregnancy 100%. Possible, as I tell you. But so much people say, you know, they have done fibroid operation and I didn't achieve pregnancy. Come on. Fertility is not a one-gender problem. No, 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 no. A man who has low sperm count may care not for it. And this woman will stay in the house after many years when fibroid comes. The whole fibroid responsible. I say, you know, my wife now become is having fibroid. Why was not the pregnancy there when the fibroid was not there? These are some of the things we need to be in position to let our people know. Doctors Save a Life Foundation is on a mission. Total health through the power of knowledge that by the year 2025, the life expectancy of our people dying because of lack of knowledge, it will be a story of the past. And this, together, we can. What you got now may not be your problem. Why not share it with somebody and deliver them from such bondage? That is much you'll be able to take today. I remain your friend, Dr. Richard Okoye. Don't forget, this program comes to you in this station every Monday by 9:30 a.m. I tell you, it's a moment you have to make it an engagement. In case you miss any of the episodes, you can visit our website, www.drsavealife.org. Right there, you will also see a number of health-profiting videos that will help us achieve this goal that is 100% possible. Thanks, and God bless you.
You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye is brought to you by Dr. Save a Life Foundation.